Hey everybody, and welcome back to my Final Cut Pro 10 tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can take your random video clips you shot and edit them together into an interesting story. This is part 3 of my series. Part 1 was about importing media and all the different options available with it, and part 2 was all about organizing and labeling all your clips so they can easily be found when you need them. I'll include the links for the first two parts in the description and up top. Please hit the like button and subscribe below if you like the videos. Also, if you have any questions or suggestions, leave me a comment below. After importing and organizing all your clips, your next step involves editing your video and crafting a story into a project. A project in Final Cut Pro is defined as a timeline-based container of clips that tell a story. Projects are stored in events in your library. You can have as many projects as you need stored in an event. As an example, you can have a project for your finished video for YouTube, a short Instagram teaser, and a slightly longer Facebook preview. Every project in Final Cut Pro is based around a primary storyline. This is what drives and sets the pace for your story. This could be a combination of sound bites and voiceovers for a documentary-style video, or a specific song for a montage-style video. By default, your clips in the storyline act as magnets. They either attract or repel each other. Above your primary storyline is where you connect your visual aspect of your story, such as cutaways, titles, transitions, etc. Below your storyline is for audio, such as background music and sound effects. Now that you have a basic understanding of projects in Final Cut Pro, I'm going to show you how to create one in my bike trip library. I'm going to right-click my Day 1 event and choose New Project. I'll name it Bike Adventures and hit Enter. A timeline opens up at the bottom of the screen. The black strip is where the primary storyline will go. I'm going to base my project on freeway clips in chronological order and use only parts I rated as favorites. I'll select the freeway collection in my Day 1 event and pick the first clip. Click on the first favorite part and drag it down into the timeline. Now I'll select my second favorite part and add it to the end of the storyline. I can drag it down, or I can press this append button and it's added to the end of my storyline. Another way to add a clip to the end of your storyline is to select it and press the E key on your keyboard. You can add more than one clip to your storyline by command-clicking a number of clips. They will be added in the same order you select them. I'm going to command-click all my freeway selects in Day 1 event and append them to my storyline in one of three ways discussed before. If all your clips don't fit on the screen, you can zoom out on your timeline by using the slider or using the command minus keyboard shortcut. You can also see the whole project by pressing Shift-Z. Just like in the browser, you can skim over the events in your timeline by hovering your mouse pointer over them. Clicking in the gray area above your clips will move the playhead there, and clicking in the clip will select that clip. You can play your project at any time by pressing the spacebar key. The playback will start from wherever your skimmer is located. You can play your project from the beginning by pressing the home key or function and back arrow on laptops to bring the playhead to the start of the project and pressing spacebar. You can also use your J, K, and L keys on your keyboard for playback. L is used to play, K is stop, pause, and J is to play in reverse. Playback will stop when the playhead reaches the end of your project. Final Cut Pro makes it very easy to alter your timeline. After watching your project, you may decide that some clips don't fit in. They are easily removed from your timeline by selecting a clip and pressing the delete key. The clip is removed from your timeline, and the clips after that are snapped to your previous clips. You can always use the undo command if you're not happy with your change. Clips can also be easily moved in the timeline. Simply select a clip and drag it over to where you want it. Do not release the mouse button just yet. A blue clip box appears to show you where the clip will be dropped. If you move it between two existing clips, it will split them apart to make room for your selected clip. Release the mouse button and your clip will be placed where the blue clip box is located. You can also modify clips in your timeline by performing a ripple trim. A ripple trim adjusts a clip's in and out point to make a clip longer or shorter without leaving a gap in the timeline. The change in clip's duration ripples outward, moving all subsequent clips earlier or later in the timeline. To ripple trim clips in your timeline, first make sure the Select tool is selected in the toolbar. Hover the mouse pointer over the end of a clip without clicking, and the pointer changes from the Select tool to Ripple Trim tool. The film strip icon will always point towards the clip you are trimming. You can zoom in on the timeline for more precision by pressing Command and equal sign keys. Select the clip you want to edit and click and drag to make it shorter or longer, and to fine-tune your cut point. The viewer display splits into two windows to show you the last frame of your clip and the first frame of the next clip. You can also use your keyboard for precision trimming your clips one frame at a time. Select the endpoint of a clip you want to edit by clicking on it. A yellow bracket will identify the selected clip. Press the comma key to remove one frame or the period key to add a frame to your clip. Reverse the comma and period keys if you are working with the beginning of a clip. I'm going to go through and ripple trim all my clips in the timeline and get rid of all the unnecessary stuff. Last thing I'm going to show you in this video is how to insert clips from your browser into the middle of your timeline. After watching your project, you may decide that you want to add some additional clips into your timeline. To add them to the end, you just simply perform an append edit like shown before. But if you want to add a clip in between two existing clips, you perform an insert edit. To do an insert edit, I'll position my playhead in between two clips in the storyline. Now in the browser, I'll select the part I want to insert with the I and O keys on my keyboard and use the W key or insert edit button to insert the selected clip into my storyline. The subsequent clips will shift over to make room for my clip I'm adding. Now I have a rough cut of my primary storyline. In my next video, I'm going to fine-tune and time my storyline. I'll also add some cutaways and layer some secondary clips over my primary storyline. Click the subscribe button so you don't miss it. Also, if you enjoy this video, hit the like button below and leave me a comment. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.